Good morning, students. In the previous topic, we have discussed about the pathogenic diseases. So, pathogenic diseases are the diseases that are caused by the various pathogens. So, these are of five types depending upon the type of organism that causes the particular disease. These are bacterial, viral, fungal, protozoan, and helminthic. So today we will discuss about the bacterial disease first. In the bacterial disease, the disease that are in your syllabus are the typhoid. So firstly, we will discuss about the typhoid. As you know from the name, the bacterial disease type is the typhoid, and it's quite obvious that it is caused by the bacteria. So the bacteria that is responsible for the cause of the typhoid is known as Salmonella typhi. The bacteria that causes the typhoid disease is known as Salmonella typhi. So it affects the small intestine of the human body. It affects the small intestine of the human body firstly, and then it migrates to the various parts of the body. Migrates to the various parts means then it goes to the different parts of the body to transmit the disease. Now, how this disease can be transmitted? This disease can be transmitted by the contaminated food or water. The reason for the causing of this disease is the intake of the contaminated food or the water. If we intake the contaminated food and water, that is the food or water that is having the Salmonella typhi bacteria in it, it is transmitted in our body through the food and water. Now, how can you detect whether someone is having the typhoid or not? So we can diagnose it by the following symptoms. First one is a constant high fever. The fever will pursue its constant high fever. Then the person suffering from this disease suffer from the weakness. There is a stomach pain. There is a constipation, headache, loss of appetite. Loss of appetite means the person suffering from this disease is not able to have food. Uski bhook mar jati hai. Loss of appetite means they don't want food. Then is the intestinal perforation. Now, what do you mean by the word intestinal perforation? Perforation means to being pores, having pores in anything. Kisi bhi cheez mein jab hum pores ho jate hain, pores bana dete hain, that particular thing is known as perforated. Aapne suna hoga perforated sheets. Means आपके पास कोई शीट है उसमें आपने छोटे छोटे होल्स बना दिए. दैट वर्ड इज नोन एज परफोरेटेड. नाउ इंटेस्टाइनल परफोरेशन मीन्स आपकी इंटेस्टाइन में छोटे छोटे से पोर्स बना देते हैं ये बैक्टीरिया, एंड दैट इन द सिवियर कंडीशंस में लेड टू द डेथ. क्योंकि अगर आपकी इंटेस्टाइन में पोर्स होंगे देन ऑल द मटीरियल विल गो डायरेक्टली इन द ब्लड and it can cause infection, and finally in the severe cases it may lead to the death. Now typhoid fever, it can be confirmed by the vital test. How can you confirm that a person is having this disease or not? By a test that is known as the vital test. One more interesting thing about the typhoid is that it was named on the cook Typhoid Mary. She was a cook. She is a sufferer of the typhoid, and she is a carrier of the typhoid because she is a cook in a mess, and for several years, around 7 or 8, she has been transmitted this disease to the different people by cooking the food. She is in a cook. She is a cook. She is in a mess, and she cooks the food for the people. And she is a carrier of the typhoid, and from the contaminated food, the different people are getting the typhoid. So this was the reason that it was named as a fever typhoid. Next, the disease that is also a bacterial disease is the pneumonia. You have commonly heard this name, pneumonia. So pneumonia is also a bacterial disease. It is caused by the bacteria. Pneumonia, it is a bacterial disease. It is very much easily observed in the small infants. Chote bachcho mein zyada dekha jata hai. Now this disease is caused by the bacteria Streptococcus. Streptococcus pneumoniae. So this disease was caused by the bacteria Streptococcus. Now what does this disease do? It affects the alveoli of the lungs. It basically attacks on the alveoli of the lungs. Now what did it do? The alveoli basically get filled with the fluid that results in the decrease of the respiratory efficiency of the lungs. The alveoli, as you know, in our lungs, there are small air-like structures. They are just like this. They are known as alveoli. Now this alveoli, they are responsible for the filling of the oxygen at the time of the process of the respiration. Now these alveoli get filled with the fluid. Now if they are filled with the fluid, then there is very less space left for the oxygen. So it decreases the respiratory efficiency of the lungs, and finally the problem arises. So how it can be transmitted? It can be transmitted by the droplets released by the infected person. The person in your contact, is if it is having a pneumonia, so through that person, through its droplets, we can get this. So while coughing or sneezing, it's always recommended to cover your mouth and nose, because it is caused by the droplet infections by sharing the glasses. Normally people, what they do, they used to share the glasses and utensils of the each other, the friends circle, the parents, the family members. What they do generally, they just share the glasses and the utensils. So eating the food in the same utensils and sharing the same glasses for drinking water or some other purposes, we can get transmitted by this disease. Now what are the symptoms of the pneumonia? So first one is the fever, high fever, cough, chills. Chills means kap kapi chutna, headache, and in the severe cases, lips and the fingers turn blue. It may be either gray to the bluish color. So in the severe cases, the lips and the fingers, they become blue. So these are the symptoms of the pneumonia. Next, we will discuss about the viral diseases. So as clear from the name, the viral diseases, they are caused by the viruses. Nowadays, which viral disease is very common? It is coronavirus. You said ki ma'am is daily taking one class of coronavirus, because nowadays coronavirus is very common, and we should not be afraid of that. We should be aware and we should take proper preventive measures to control that. So in the viral disease, it's common. It is caused by the various viruses. First one is the common cold. You all are very familiar of this word, that is the common cold, and it is a viral disease. Normally aap log doctor ke paas jaate ho, cold hua, cough hua, so doctor normal says viral hai. So what is that? It's common cold. It is a viral disease. It is caused by the group of the viruses that is called rhinoviruses. Common cold, it is caused by the group of viruses that is known as a rhinovirus. It affects our nose and the respiratory passages and the respiratory organ, but it doesn't attack our lung. Jo common cold hai, that will affect your nose, that will affect your respiratory passage. Respiratory passage means your windpipe through which respiration occurs, and the respiratory organs, various respiratory organs, but not the lungs. So the attack of the common cold lasts for 3 to 7 days. Normally आप लोगों ने ये एक बात सुनी होंगी in your families कि cold हुआ है कोई बात नहीं 3-4 दिन में ठीक हो जाएगा. Because the severity of this is of the, you can say the time period of this or duration of this is lastly up to minimum 3 days and maximum 7 days. Now how it can be transmitted? It can be transmitted by the direct inhalation of the droplets. Firstly, it is transmitted by the direct inhalation of the droplets. I again told you, if the person is having the common cold and we came in contact of that person, and if that person sneezes or coughs in front of us without covering his or her mouth and nose, we are in the direct contact, and once we inhale that droplets in our body, we will also get infected. So from the direct inhalation of the droplets from cough and sneezing of the infected person, through the contaminated objects, through the contaminated object means the person, if the infected person touch that objects, and we are again touching that objects of the infected person, so we are getting that particular disease. Normally you have seen in your family, if one of the person is having the common cold or viral in the family, 90% of the cases all the family members, they do also get transmitted, also get infected from that particular disease. This is because we people don't use any precautions regarding that, and as a result we also get infected. Suppose I am giving you example, it's very common in a classroom or in a family. In a classroom, your friend is having a common cold. He is using his pen. Now his pen is get infected, his pen is get contaminated. There are the droplets of the common cold on that particular pen. After 5 minutes or the 10 minutes, you took that pen and you started writing. Now what you will have, you will also get infected from the common cold. Similarly, in the family, we are sharing same hand towels, we are sharing same utensils, we are having sharing same glasses, we are even we are sharing the mobile phones and the remotes. Suppose one of the member is having the common cold, he or she use the remotes for changing the channel, and after 5 minutes you took the remote and you will also start changing the channel. Now that remote is contaminated, and if you took that remote, you also get infected. But nowadays people are aware, now we use the things by sanitizing them, by washing our hands again and again to prevent us from coronavirus. Similarly, if we take precautions like this in every moment of our life, we can also prevent ourselves from the simple viral disease like the common cold. Now, what are the symptoms of the common cold? First one is the nasal congestion. Nasal congestion, nasal word is related with your nose. So nasal passage, nasal congestion means aapke nose mein, aapke nasal passage mein, there is a congestion. Congestion means blockage. Then is the sore throat, gala kharab hona. Your throat is not working properly. Hoarseness, jise hum kehte hain ghode jaisi awaaz hona. Aapki awaaz jo hai bhari ho jati hai. Next is the discharge, that is a running nose. Cough, headache, tiredness, these are the symptoms of the common cold. Now next we will proceed to the next viral disease, that is the dengue. Dengue is a viral disease. Now you people will say ki dengue is caused by the biting of the mosquito, so how it is a viral disease? So because that mosquito is just a vector of that particular virus, and that's why dengue is a viral disease. I told you on the topic of pathogenic diseases that some of the pathogenic diseases are caused by the vectors. Now this mosquito is not the real organism that is causing the disease. The real organism is the virus. But to spread this virus, this mosquito plays an important role. So dengue fever, it is called caused by the virus flavivirus. Right? So this virus caused the dengue fever. It is transmitted by the bite of the mosquito, as I told you. And how it is transmitted? If one of the four dengue virus serotypes are present in that particular infected mosquito, that will bite our body and we will get our disease. Now, what do you mean by one of the four dengue virus serotypes? One of the four means there are the four strains of the dengue virus, and serotypes means any one of the medium, they are present in a medium. If any one of the strain is present in that particular mosquito, then we will get infected from the dengue fever. Now it will affect the infants, young children, adult, and its symptoms last from 3 to 14 days. The virus is common cold. The duration of the common cold is 3 to 7 days, but the duration of the dengue fever is about 3 to 14 days after the infective bite. If the mosquito bites you, it doesn't mean that you will get the dengue. If that particular mosquito is affected by the virus, only then you will get the dengue fever. So there is no vaccine till date of dengue fever. Aaj tak koi bhi vaccine nahi batni hai. No specific medicine of dengue is there. आप लोगों ने सुना होगा डेंगू फीवर इट्स क्वाइट नॉर्मल. जब डेंगू हो जाता है तो लोग कहते हैं कि सिर्फ रेस्ट करो एंड ड्रिंक प्लेंटी ऑफ फ्लूइड्स. ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा पानी पियो, नारियल पानी पिलाने लग जाते हैं, जूसेस पिलाने लग जाते हैं, थोड़ी थोड़ी देर बाद इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स, नींबू पानी, ये सारी चीज़ें पीने को कहते हैं, डॉक्टर्स भी रिकमेंड करते हैं. दिस इज़ बिकॉज क्योंकि डेंगू फीवर जो है उसकी कोई स्पेसिफिक वैक्सीन नहीं है टिल डेट एंड नो स्पेसिफिक ट्रीटमेंट इज़ देयर. So what doctors generally do, they just give medicines to cope up the symptoms, to reduce the symptoms. Jo symptoms hame dikh rahe hain, unko reduce karne ke liye medicines di jaati hain, not to cure the disease. Jaise ki fever ho raha hai to paracetamol de di jayegi ki aap thoda sa aapka fever jo hai kam ho jayega. Pain reduce karne ke liye aap logo ko पेन किलर्स दे देंगे, आइब्रोफिन दे देंगे. सो दीज आर द मेडिसिन डैट आर रिकमेंडेड टू रिड्यूस द सिम्टम्स. देयर इज नो एग्जैक्ट क्योर ऑफ दिस सिम्टम, सॉरी ऑफ दिस डिजीज. सो दे कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड ओनली बाय टेकिंग प्रिकॉशंस. मीन्स एट दिस टाइम द ब्लड प्लेटलेट्स ऑफ आवर बॉडी स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू कीप आवर बॉडी हाइड्रेटेड. नो हाउ यू कैन हाइड्रेट योर बॉडी? बाय taking the plenty of the drinks. And why it is recommended to take rest during the this dengue fever? It is recommended to take rest so that the energy of your body can be utilized to recover your body, rather you utilize your energy in the different works. So symptoms of the dengue fever are the high fever, severe headache, pain behind the eyes, muscle and joint pain, and in some cases there may be rashes also. Next viral disease that is in your syllabus is chikungunya. As from the name, it is not caused by the chicken. Its just name is the chikungunya. It is caused by the virus that is the alpha virus. It's a alpha virus that causes the chikungunya disease, and we called it the chikungunya virus. It is a alpha virus basically, which is known as chikungunya virus that causes this disease. It is also spread through the bite of the mosquito, and that mosquito is transmitted by the affected mosquito. And this mosquito is known as, the name of this mosquito is known as Aedes aegypti. It is Aedes aegypti. So as you know, the malaria is caused by the Anopheles mosquito. Similarly, this chikungunya is transmitted by the mosquito that is known as Aedes aegypti. And even the chikungunya doesn't have any specific treatment, same as in the case of the dengue fever. The doctors will recommend the medicines just to reduce the symptoms of the chikungunya. So the best prevention of the chikungunya is to control the overall control of the mosquitoes. How you can control the mosquitoes? So by avoiding the bite of the infected mosquitoes. In this way we can control the chikungunya. Excuse me. So you can control this by the avoiding the spread of the mosquito, by controlling the mosquito breeding, by putting the medicines to control the mosquito, and by protecting yourselves under the mosquito's net, so that you can control yourself or you can avoid yourself from the biting of the mosquito. That's all about the bacterial and viral disease. We will discuss the next disease in the next lecture. Thank you, students.